Jesse Pinkman has a case for being one of the greatest supporting characters of all time. Breaking Bad is perhaps the greatest show ever made. It is definitely up there for me, with such a powerful conclusion that feels so definitive and earth-shattering to the characters that inhabit it. However, while it was incredibly satisfying seeing Jesse escape captivity and be free of Walter White as he drives off into the night, we have no idea where he is going. And while I am perfectly happy to get that ending and speculate for myself, Vince Gilligan's understanding of this character is so clear, and he strives to provide a much more concrete conclusion to the character in El Camino. Jesse's arc across Breaking Bad is one of the more interesting ones, as he easily becomes one of my favorite characters in the show. He goes from a kid who just wants to make some money to a man that has gotten himself in too deep with the wrong people and can't let go of a life that continues to haunt him. To me, no one suffers as much as this character, and after all the trauma he has been through, El Camino is the film that illustrates Jesse's road to redemption. El Camino opens with Mike suggesting that Alaska would be a great place for a fresh start, which sets the whole film in motion, as Mike was someone who briefly did take Jesse under his wing and tried to protect him from the pain that will be caused from Walter White. Jesse has had trouble finding his own direction and path in life. He has mostly always needed the influence and almost approval of the people he looks up to, which is why Walter has manipulated him so easily throughout the show, because he knows that. The only time where it felt like for a minute that Jesse may escape and find that true independence was in season 2 of Breaking Bad, when he was with Jane, but we know how that turns out. This is an element of El Camino that I think Vince Gilligan subtly explores, and he does it so well, as Jesse is now forced to fend for himself and find that peace. The path that he has gone down led him to seeing people he cared about being murdered in front of him, and having him go through absolute torture in the final season, which is yet another thing that he confronts within this film. A lot of this trauma is brought on from Todd, who is one of the most interesting characters in Breaking Bad, and he continues to be that in El Camino, as we explore more of these power dynamics and the true grip he had over Jesse. El Camino utilizes flashbacks to provide context for why Jesse is going to certain locations. These scenes show that Todd hides his money secretly in his house, and Jesse has to help him dispose of a dead body. The conclusion of this masterful scene where Jesse has a potential ticket to freedom as he takes Todd's gun. Now, he could have easily shot Todd and escaped as he was unarmed. However, Todd calmly just talks him down and takes the gun from Jesse without having to raise his voice or attack him. This illustrated the true power he had over Jesse, who has become so beaten and broken from this physical and emotional torture that he can't even find that brief moment of courage to make his escape. This scene makes the Breaking Bad ending all the more sweeter when Jesse finally takes that leap and chokes Todd to death. The other captor he had throughout his life is a strange one, because he never really had him by force. Walter White, one of the greatest characters in history, does his best to drag Jesse down to the depths, but the good will and heart of Jesse is the only thing that really prevents him from being someone like Walter. With that said, the complexities of this relationship you could easily talk about for hours, because it is that layered and rich. Jesse, in a way, has always looked up to Walter. He respects his intelligence and the way that he can think his way out of any situation. The ending of the show proves that. He had every possible card stacked against him, and he gets the best possible ending with the cards he was dealt. The money will still go to Walter Jr., and he died from his own plans, not by getting caught or really losing, he went out undefeated. I think the ending of El Camino is so touching because it plays on all of Jesse's influences and the people that impacted him quite significantly. And for Jesse to go through this redemption arc, he needs to confront moments from these influences. I think the scene between Walter and Jesse here is a beautiful example of that. He doesn't try to remember all the pain and suffering he got put through. Instead, he remembers one of the nicest things that Walter ever said to him.
You're really lucky, you know that? You didn't have to wait your whole life to do something special.
These moments in Jesse's life are perhaps where he is the most fulfilled. The man he looks up to highlights the potential he has and even expresses envy for Jesse. He is also gotten out and a happy life ahead of him with Jane. There is such potential there. This is a perfect time to talk about Jane, a character who always had such an impact on Jesse and completely changed him when she died. We all know the impact Jane had on Jesse in season 2. She is someone that caused a divide between Jesse and Walt, but that only felt like it was due to Jesse getting some agency over his own life. Walter always held Jesse under his thumb, and in the earlier seasons, you think it's just to stop Jesse from getting in his own way, but as Breaking Bad unravels its narrative in the later seasons, you realize Walter is someone that is really only protecting his own interests. He cares about Jesse, but not in a normal way. He's willing to hurt the people Jesse cares about to get him to be under his thumb and doing what he needs from him. That is why the ending of El Camino is so sweet, because in those final moments, we get one last scene between Jesse and Jane, where she says one of the most poignant lines in the whole film.
I've gone where the universe takes me my whole life. It's better to make those decisions for yourself.
What she says not only fits into where they were in season 2, once again making Breaking Bad even richer, but it gives Jesse that confirmation and confidence to take this leap of faith and start taking agency of his own life and being comfortable with that, because there's a lot of uncertainty in Jesse's future as he's driving off with a new identity and a completely new landscape on life. El Camino may not be everyone's favorite piece from the Breaking Bad saga, but it is no less necessary to tell this final tale for Jesse. El Camino is just as much of a narrative about a mental battle as it is about Jesse finding his freedom. The film finally gives Jesse complete freedom, and I think that couldn't have been more of a fitting end to this character. While Walter White and Saul Goodman got the punishments that they were deserving of for not letting go of this life, Jesse was tortured, even though he ultimately wanted out of a life that caused so much pain for so many people. And finally, El Camino gives Jesse what he has ultimately been looking for: redemption.